Hi everybody! My name is Marissa and I have a bachelor's degree in mathematics with a minor in statistics. In today's lesson, I will discuss parameters for proportions and means. When we want to answer a research question using statistics, we ask questions about parameters. A parameter is a value that represents an entire population, whereas a statistic is used to estimate a parameter. We use different parameters based on our research question. The five parameters we will discuss today are 1 population proportion, difference in 2 population proportions, 1 population mean of paired differences, and difference in 2 population means. The 5 parameters we will be discussing today are either going to be in the form of proportions or means. We will begin by discussing proportions. Our first proportion is the proportion used for 1 population. This parameter is denoted by a lowercase p, and its corresponding statistic is p hat, which is denoted by a p with a caret on top. It is important to note that p hat is used to estimate p. Examples of research questions that use p and p hat would be, what percentage of teenagers 16 to 18 have a driver's license? Or, what proportion of students at a university graduate in 4 years? Sometimes we want to use proportions to compare 2 groups. When we do this, we use the difference between 2 population proportions as our parameter. The parameter is denoted by p(1) minus p(2). And the statistic is denoted by p(1) minus p(2). Examples of research questions interested in the difference in 2 population proportions are, what is the difference in the proportion of American married females under 25 in 1960 versus 1920? Or, what is the difference in the proportion of people who exercise regularly for adults age 18 to 22 versus adults 23 to 27? We will now discuss parameters used for the population mean, starting with 1 population mean. The parameter for 1 population mean is mu, and is denoted by the Greek letter mu. Its accompanying statistic is x bar, denoted by an x with a horizontal line over it. Note that x bar is used to estimate mu. Examples of research questions interested in estimating mu would be, what is the average height for women in the United States, or what is the average amount of time math majors spend on homework each night? What if we were interested in the differences between the same group of individuals before and after some type of treatment? In this case, we would use the population mean of paired differences as our parameter. We obtain this value by subtracting each observation's before value from their after value, or vice versa, depending on if we think the value should be higher or lower than the before value. Data like this is called paired data. The parameter that represents the mean difference of paired data is mu(d), and the statistic is d bar. An example of a research question interested in the value of mu(d) would be, what is the difference in weight for people before versus after starting a diet program? Or, what is the mean difference in income for graduates before versus after obtaining a master's degree? When we want to know the difference in means between 2 populations, we use the parameter mu(1) minus mu(2) and x(1) minus x(2) as the statistic. Some research questions about the difference in 2 population means would be, what is the difference between the mean mile time for males versus females? And what is the difference between the mean cost of a house in 1960 versus 2022? Let's test our knowledge on parameters by doing a quick exercise. A scientist is interested in whether or not mice will gain weight after consuming an artificial sweetener. She plans on weighing each mouse before and after consuming artificial sugar for 1 week. What parameter and accompanying statistic is the scientist interested in? We would use the population mean for paired differences. We know the data is paired because we are using the same mice and comparing their differences in weight before and after a treatment. Great job, everyone! Today we learned about parameters for proportions. We also learned about parameters for means. Thanks for watching, and please be sure to check out other videos about statistics lessons and applications here on Chegg. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.